So the Mars Ice Challenge is a challenge hosted by NASA. So in recent years, they've discovered subsurface ice deposits on Mars that are not too far underground. And so being able to access these ice deposits would make missions to Mars much more feasible, mainly because by accessing the ice deposits and then getting the resulting water, you can not only drink that water, but you can also use it in a chemical reaction with the CO2 in the atmosphere to produce methane, which can be used as a rocket fuel. And so if you can make your own rocket fuel there, you save a lot of money in sending rocket fuel to Mars.
For senior design, we're evaluated based on to what degree does our solution fulfill a need. And we decided that because this competition exists, we're already set up to fulfill a really important need. So that gives us the opportunity to focus on creating the best solution possible.
Well, our robot is designed to drill through the Martian soil and then into the ice and extract a core of ice and clay and then dump the ice into a melting chamber where it would be melted and then pass through a filtration system and then dump the clay off to the side and then begin drilling a new hole.
It's very interdisciplinary. A lot of times we can get pretty centered on like, this is mechanical engineering, so we're just gonna deal with this spring, we're gonna deal with this force, or this electronic, but this has like really been an opportunity to say, since I'm getting 2 degrees, like it's been a great opportunity for me to say, this is mechanical engineering, this is geology. This is where we can put them both together and make something that really makes a difference.
One of the biggest challenges that we faced was creating a robust coring drill that fits our needs, because nothing really exists out there that does what we need. There's one company that makes something close to what we want, but it's well outside of our price range. So we've been really working hard to create this drill from scratch.
When that drill, you know, goes into the ice, that's going to be a very exciting moment. Yeah, just like seeing that, like, the things that you thought of in your head are actually like coming together and for the most part working. Of course, it's not going to work the first time, like, ever, but eventually, like, it just starts working. You're just like, hey, we did this. Like, this comes from us. There's 6 of us and we're building like this giant system.
I guess a favorite part of this has been like working on an actual project with a goal that's not just a grade. At the end of the day, like, there's a lot, we take a lot of classes at Penn and we do a lot of great things, but this project was something that we started from the beginning. We started from nothing. There was no guidelines given to us of, hey, you should make it this way or you should do it this way. We were able to take a problem that we thought was reasonable. You know, we got some constraints from NASA, but we were able to say, okay, we're gonna tackle a big problem. We're gonna do something that hopefully will have an impact, like, even outside this world. So I think that was like the most interesting part about this whole process.